Ready. Morning guys, welcome back to another video. I hope you're all having a great day. I know I am with the beautiful sunshine. Hope you all had an amazing 4th of July celebration. We sure did, as you can tell, remnant of the fireworks display. Quite the fireworks display. Oh man, I got a serious problem. It's a little packed. It's a packed driveway. We did some celebrating, having fun with friends and family. I got to go out with my buddy Randy. He put on an epic fireworks display, probably one of the best I've seen at a person's house. Just absolutely incredible. Brought the Camaro out for the first time in a couple of weeks, and got covered, absolutely covered with fireworks cardboard. It was parked an okay distance away, but just the amount of chaos. You can tell, and I had just cleaned her before, so never make that mistake. Never clean your car and then go see fireworks, because it is so disgusting. We just busted out the power wash. We're just gonna clean her up a little bit and take it over to the storage unit, organize a couple of things, and then we're going to meet a guy in Kennebunk, because he's got some wheels and tires for the Camaro, stock wheels and tires. So we're gonna pick those up, see how they look. I just want to get something on the car other than these, because these are nasty. They've been painted, they've been plasti dipped. You can see the remnants of the plasti dip. I got to take them off. I'm gonna paint the calipers at one point and get those all cleaned up, because these are winter tires, and obviously we can't be using those at the track, because I do want to go to the track later this week and see what she's got at the track. One thing that really upsets me about this car is the positive offset in the front. The wheels stick in far too much. The rear is not that bad, but the front is terrible. And I don't want to do spacers in the front, so these are stock wheels that I'm going to pick up, so it's probably exactly the same thing. But later on down the line, I'd like to get the correct amount of poke, just with the body line right in line, and maybe lower it just a little bit. But I want to set her up for a street and strip. I want to have fun on the road with her and fun at the track. As far as other cars go, we have the Audi. We did get the Audi back here. So she is up with us. She's dirty from the trip up. Wow. Man, this front bumper is chipped. You can see it really bad in the sun. Look how bad this front bumper is, guys. Oh my God. Hopefully that didn't happen just on the way up here, because that is terrible. That is so bad, all the clear coat. She's going up for sale. I just don't need her anymore. I don't drive her. And she came up just fine on the trailer. The trailer did excellent. The Duramax did excellent. Oh my goodness. Oh, good gracious. We went up to camp, as they say in Maine. And yeah, we got a little sappy. We stuck under some pine trees and towed the camper just fine. And towed the Audi just fine. I gotta say, the Duramax is doing work, but we did have a problem with that pesky V-band again. She did fall off. I went and ordered the correct one. It's a 3-inch V-band that I need, and I think that might be a 3.5. That's why the problem of it not, it's being clamped right at the tip. I even tried shaving both ends of the V-band clamp just to get a little extra out of it. Didn't work. So sucked it up, paid the 20 something bucks to get a real 3-inch V-band clamp for the old Duramax. So other than that, she's good to roll. So we're just gonna clean up this Camaro real quick, sweet cheeks, give her a bath, and then be on her way. You know, she's got a good tone. Sweet Cheeks has a very nice tone. One of these days I'm gonna get her on the lift and find out exactly what this exhaust system consists of. Because right now, let's see here. It's a little hard to see. Way too dark for you guys to tell like what is going on here. But just for my sake, definitely has little, we'll call those resonators. It's got the cat. So it has no H-pipe or X-pipe. And I think that's where she's lacking. As far as the quality of the sound of the LS3 is, it doesn't have that H-pipe or X-pipe. X-pipe like I want. I want an X-pipe. And I'd love to have cutouts. So when I'm at the track, I can just hit the electronic cutouts and really have that aggressive sound. Oh man, she's still dirty. I need to wipe her down. Give her proper. Oh, she's nasty. She's nasty, but we're here to pick up a couple of things. I needed a cord. Let's open her up and you can see what the hell's going on since the last video. It's been a little bit. It's been a little bit. Judgment-free zone here. Absolute mess. So this is what's left over from my room, closet, just a bunch of stuff. But this is the bike that we brought up last week. Got the two dirt bikes sitting. One's right there. So this is a nightmare. This is my nightmare. I clear off all of this. We're gonna get the sled deck back into the back of the Duramax once I fix the exhaust, because I really don't like driving it with the downpipe just dumping right there. Sounds terrible. I need to get the engine hoist back to hooks it this week so we can get the motor for the Tacoma, which is sitting at Rob's right now. Everything else for the 5.3 build that we're doing, all the miscellaneous parts, oil pan cover, all that good stuff. We need to get that out of here and up here and figure out what to do with the Tacoma motor, because I'm still not sure what to do with that. This year, like I said, I want to get some good tires on it. I have it, I'm still going to trailer it because the track is about an hour away from where I live now. So if anything breaks, I do have triple A, or at least I think I do. I don't know. So I could tow it, but I'd rather not tow it. I'd rather just trailer it, not run the risk of breaking something, breaking an axle, breaking God knows what, and being stuck at the track. So we will be trailering Sweet Cheeks back and forth, Wednesday and Friday nights, street nights, whatever is available for whatever week. I just want to go. Weekends are fully booked throughout the summer, so I won't be able to do any real events till fall as far as the dragway goes, but just getting it there to a street night or two and getting some content for you guys. So that's plans for Sweet Cheeks for this year. I would like to get the Tacoma up here at least for the fall and start building the chassis a bit. I'm not sure if I'm going to notch out the rear of the frame. Something's always going on. Every single time I do a video, notch the frame and do all this work, and the 5.3 that I'm building, I'm going to see if it fits in the Tacoma. That's where my head's at right now. It changes. It changes every day. Every day I change my mind. So that's where I'm at right now for this video. Give me 1 second. We'll go meet this guy and hopefully we'll have some wheels and tires on Sweet Cheeks. One more try. Bye guys. Have a good day. Behave yourselves. Don't do anything I won't do. All right, we're on our way to go pick up these wheels and tires. Check back with you after that, okay?
The New Hampshire State Police has activated the New Hampshire Emergency Alert System in order to conduct the required monthly test. This activation of the New Hampshire Emergency Alert.
You know, I do talk a lot of crap about this truck as far as all the problems go with it, what it needs, and but as I've said before, this truck is a fun around the town truck. It's just the noises are cool.
get looks because it's an older Cummins, and you know, it's just an overall fun truck to drive. It's slow. 37s don't help with that at all. But just laying into the pedal, it's so slow, you're not going fast, and it sounds amazing. Like, lay into it. It's pretty fun. Don't get me wrong, Camaro is a blast, but I get questions all the time. Why do you have so many vehicles? It's because they're all different. They're all different. They all have their own little thing. And for me to be able to switch between all four of them at any point, it just makes it fun. That's why. I'm not satisfied with just driving one vehicle. I'd rather have day to day, figure out what I want and do it. So, but this truck is fun. This is a fun truck.
All right. And just like that, had some wheels and tires. It's not a one-hand thing. There we go. Okay. She's down. So these are essentially the same exact wheels and tires that I have now. They're just not black. They're not plastic dip black. So, and they actually have tread and not winter tires. So a couple of things going for them. Let me get up here. So they have seen better days, just like my rims. Guy says they were balanced. Obviously they have some curbing issues in the fronts. A little bit of ding there. So this is, these are probably just gonna be a temporary tire for the track this week when I go down with a Camaro to do street night. These will be streetable tires that shouldn't give anyone problems as far as letting me race. So these will just be a temporary fix until I get a actual set of wheels and tires that I want to keep around. These are pretty decent tires. They run flats. They're 275/35Z20 in the rear and 245 in the front. It is what it is. You get what you pay for, and these were pretty cheap, relatively speaking, so I'm happy. We're gonna drop them off at the storage unit, bring Sweet Cheeks back over here, jack her up, get these tires on, and set her up for Friday to go down to the track. So I just hop off, put these inside, and we'll get these wheels on, and we'll see what it looks like.
I'm excited.
Okay, boys and girls, it's a little bit later in the day today. Still beautiful out, still a beautiful day. And so this is what we got. This is what we got right here. It's like my first video. If you haven't seen my first video, go back and watch it. It's very similar. Still the same crappy content, right? I think the same glasses too. I don't know, go down my first video, go find my first one. I'm pretty sure I'm wearing the same glasses and different car. I told you, different cars. I only had the Audi, you know, like a year ago when I started doing this channel, so pretty cool. Pretty cool to see the progression, I guess. But anywho, I'll end it here. If you guys aren't subscribed, I appreciate a subscription, maybe a like, and we'll see you at the dragway this Friday. How about that? Fingers crossed I don't break anything. All right. You guys are great. I love you. Keep it weird. We'll catch you next time. Thanks for watching.